Hey folks, John Ferguson Smart here for another session on some practical tips about how to run your automated tests better, faster, and more reliably. So in today's session, what I want to look at is how to run Cucumber scenarios in parallel with Browserstack. So a common problem for a long time is that running Cucumber scenarios in parallel is quite difficult, but with the most recent versions of Cucumber and JUnit and Serenity BDD, this becomes a lot easier, and that's what we're going to look at. So what I'm going to demo is this little set of feature files we have. If you look in the hierarchy here, we have a dozen or so feature files. Each feature file has a number of different scenarios. There are some scenario outlines. So there are a few, maybe a dozen or so scenarios spread out over the whole test suite. The idea of this is so that we can demo running these feature files in parallel and that I can point out some of the traps that you're likely to fall into when you're working, running them in parallel locally and with Browserstack. Now, when you're running a tool like Browserstack, which I have open over here, we can run a certain number of tests in parallel, and it does help our test execution. We can also run on any environment we want. It gives us a lot of flexibility. We don't have to set up different operating systems and different browsers and so forth. Now, in my environment, I can run up to 5 parallel threads, and this is important. Because one of the problems you can run into when you're running a tool like Browserstack is that if you overload the threads, if you run 20 parallel scenarios on your local machine and they send requests to Browserstack, Browserstack gets overloaded and starts rejecting requests and you get failing tests. So we don't want that. And for a long time, Cucumber had trouble managing that. So what I want to show you is how to deal with that. The first thing, so we're working with JUnit, we're working with Cucumber, JUnit 5, Cucumber, and Serenity BDD. So what we have here is our JUnit runner. We have one JUnit runner for the whole class. And the important thing here is we have the include engine Cucumber because we're working with Cucumber tests, but we also have a plugin property called IO Cucumber Core Plugins Serenity Report Parallel. Serenity Reporter Parallel, really important. There are a few others, like Pretty and the Timeline, don't have to worry about them. They're just to add a little bit of extra reporting as we execute. But the important thing is this IO Cucumber Core Plugin Serenity Reporter Parallel. Now, where does that come from? That comes from the Serenity Cucumber dependencies. So when we import Serenity Cucumber, we get that one in the dependencies. So when we run this, this will run our tests in parallel. But there's a trick. Because to run JUnit and Cucumber tests in parallel, we need another configuration file. We actually need two configuration files. The first one is the JUnit platform properties file. And this is where we have configuration for both JUnit and Cucumber to run our tests in parallel. Here we can see a whole set of JUnit configuration, which I'll look at in another video. But the most important ones are actually down here. Now you notice here, this is, I'll put the link to this in the video. This sample project has a whole lot of different ways you can configure your Cucumber execution. But the interesting one, what we've got down here, this is what we need to do when we run using Browserstack or any similar types of platform. We need to be able to limit the number of threads. Now, to limit the number of threads, so what we do, first of all, we set Cucumber execution parallel enabled. We set that to true. And then, here's the tricky bit, we set the strategy to fixed and the Cucumber execution parallel config fixed parallelism to 4. But that's not enough. We also need to set the max pool size to to 4, so that we really lock in that limit and ensure that we don't exceed 4 threads, because if we do, browser stack explodes and we get failing tests for no good reason. We can also, I've got, this is actually redundant, but we can also say cucumber.plugin and specify the Serenity report here if we don't want to do it at the test script level. So either will work. The other thing we need to configure when we're running BrowserStack is in the Serenity conf. Now this configuration is enough to run our feature files in parallel, but to wire up BrowserStack, we need to do some other setups. So in our Serenity conf file, which is right here, we have a number of options. We have our default web driver options. We've got some default Serenity options, but more importantly, what we do is we set up the environments, and the environments is how you can set up different configuration environments in Serenity. So I have a local, a prod, a Chrome setup, Edge, Firefox, and so forth. I'm going to uncomment this one so that we run our tests using the BrowserStack environment. The BrowserStack environment is down here, this one. So if we look at it, what's in the BrowserStack environment? Well, we set up a home page, but more importantly, we set up WebDriver. Now, everything under here, when we set the environment, everything here acts as a top level configuration property. So WebDriver driver is remote. The remote URL is created by this URL here, where we pass in the BrowserStack user and the BrowserStack key. And those BrowserStack user and BrowserStack key, well, that comes from your configuration. You can get them when you're, I think it'll be in the profile somewhere here, you can go and get them from the site and set them up as environment variables. They're by far the easiest way to work with BrowserStack. So you just define an environment variable user, environment variable key, and Serenity can read this in your conf file. Then a couple more things we need to do. In the capabilities section, when we wanted to find the browser, we set the browser to Chrome in this case. And then we have this BStack options. Now that is where we define all the BrowserStack specific attributes. So we can define things like the OS version, the resolution, the Selenium version, even the whether we want to record video, the timeout, and so forth. Now timeout, you do want to be a little bit careful with this. You generally want a fairly large timeout. So here I've got an idle timeout of 5 minutes. Normally it's not a problem, but when you're running tests in parallel, sometimes because it's switching threads, individual tests may, as outliers, may take longer to run than you would normally expect. And, or even if they run quickly, the way that Serenity works is it will wait till the end of the execution to shut everything down and to produce the reports. So you need to have this idle timeout as a fairly high number. So I put it to 5 minutes. I could put it higher than that. I could put it to 10 minutes if I wanted to. Just to be sure that we give BrowserStack enough time, we tell it that, hey, we're running all the tests, we're going to wait to the end before we do all the processing and generate the reports. So once we've done all that, we can then go and run our Cucumber test suite. And what we'll see is that at the IDE level, you can see it's kicking off multiple tests. So even in the example tables, we've got multiple examples running. So I've got a test running here, a test running here, one running here, one running here, 4 running in parallel and in on our BrowserStack dashboard. If I refresh this, we can see these tests, 4 of them running in parallel, or 3 of them. It's actually got 5. Okay, so it's opened up 5 threads. This one is one that I cancelled, I think. Should be a few more running. Yep, so there we have, we're starting to get quite a few coming through here. So we've got 3 of them passing, 2. We've got this number which changes a little bit as the execution runs, and we can see them still running away in parallel. And you see it is going through quite quickly. So you can see the tests since it is running them in parallel, we are getting a fairly nice speed gain. Individually, they take the time they take, but because we're running them together, and BrowserStack is a very nice environment, a platform for that, allows us to run our tests in parallel quite effectively. We don't lose too much time in the exchange, and we end up with our fully running tests in a minute, 1 minute 37 seconds, which isn't too bad considering the number of tests. I think it would have taken about 3 minutes to run had I run them sequentially. Three, four minutes. So we're getting a decent sort of gain. So that's what I wanted to show you in this video. Hopefully that's shown you how to set up BrowserStack and Cucumber and run your Cucumber scenarios in parallel in BrowserStack and not get yourself into trouble with those parallel threads and timeouts that I was talking about. And if you found the video useful, as always, don't forget to subscribe on the button at the bottom of the video.